Hi, good morning. Welcome back. Well, guess what time it is? It's tractor time again. Like I said in my previous video, I want to knock off that topsoil that's left over. I want to go put it where the campsite's going to be, flatten that out. And if whatever's left over, I'm going to bring it out where I pulled some of the branches away from that big pile. And it's a gorgeous day, so join me. Let's have fun again. Thanks for being there.
In some topsoil and make this nice. All right, let's do it.
Okay, I broke down the little slope that was there, and I'm going to bring some topsoil there, and whatever is left, maybe I'll bring a couple more for next spring. I have some spots that after the snow and everything, so I'll bring some topsoil here, level that out. It's going to be better now coming up instead of zigzagging.
Happy with that. Have a bit there left over for next spring. That's how it turns out. So I think we're good here. And now I'm gonna dump some in the back.
So here is the next day. Less sun coming through the trees. It's pretty cloudy. We got some rain earlier, so we'll get a better view of what it looks like. I think it turned out pretty nice. There's still that little ridge here, but I got enough room over there to put the tent. It's an 8x14, so I think this is going to be a nice spot for next summer for them to come and camp, the whole family. If not, we'll make adjustments accordingly. There's the other spot where I added some topsoil. This sloped down pretty much. That's one reason why I'd put all the branches here over the years. But now we're kind of fed up of seeing it here. So that's why we want to move it over there where it's further away from the house. And I'll gradually add topsoil as we go. But now this topsoil will give me that possibility to go reach on top here and maybe just not take it all out, but make it flatter and then add topsoil on it.
Dusty and dry? No.
I just did a bit of raking and threw down some seeds, grass seeds. And over there where it's a bit darker, right here, it was more compact, so I took a big rake and I fluffed it up a bit. So we'll see what comes out of this, but there's a lot of crabgrass and I'm afraid those little seeds might be there next spring. We'll have to treat them next spring with something. I don't know what, but we don't have a lot of choices here in Canada to treat crabgrass. Just that cornmeal stuff, that's like a preventer, doesn't do a good job. So that's it.
Decided to dry her up a bit. I'm gonna deserve a beer. I mean a beverage. She's a beaut.
Just doing a little infomercial. If you guys are interested in beer glasses, this applies to Canadian residents. Princess Otto has these beer glasses, a set of four. And my son happened to buy me one box and gave it to me as a gift. So, Metzir, thank you very much. So, I'll put the part number for Princess Otto for these glasses. Now I'm going to drink that beer. Bye bye.
Oh boy, that was close.
All right, I'm tired. It was a long day, got a lot accomplished. Finished a little campground, campsite, whatever. Filled some of the leftover topsoil where I've got my pile of branches that I want to reduce. So that's going to give me a bit of an extension to go and grab more. And finished laying out the topsoil that was left over, so no more blue tarp in the front yard. So now it's time to go and relax and have a cold one, a cold beverage. Something that goes in one of these How We Roll by Kubota. Oh, and I know just what. Oop. Nice and cold. Now that's a perfect pour. So, How We Roll Kubota glasses, beer glasses, like I did in my little commercial. Go check it out. So if you like this kind of video, don't forget to hit the like, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Ding ding. And I guess we'll catch you on the next one. So take care, stay safe, and bye for now. See you guys.